I think there are certain key words when we talk about basketball players, like intangibles, motor, how hard do they play? And you notice he kept point, I'm a competitor. Like, we can talk about what aspects of his game are great, but Isaiah, when you see him play, he's ripping the ball from other guys. He's trying to dunk on people. There's a ferociousness to his game.
Yeah, key word, competitor. I mean, he likes to compete. He will compete. And that's something that you really can't teach. I mean, that's just something that you either have that or you don't. And he seems to have that competition gene that wants to make him go out and try to be the best. I think playing under Coach K and spending a little time at Duke under Coach K, under his guidance, as we know, people from North Carolina in Duke, those players that get good coaching in that ACC from there, they come out and they want to compete. And Zion is a guy who will compete.
I like what you said when you talk about a competitor having that competitive competitiveness and wanting to go out there and always do your best, because there are some guys that they have the skill, but they're low motor.
Mm-hmm.
And you can't teach a guy to be high motor. Like, if you don't have the skill, there have been plenty of guys that have come into this league that couldn't shoot and they learned how to shoot, or they couldn't really handle, they improved their ball handling, or they improved their free throw shooting, post moves, etc. You can improve your skills. But there haven't been a lot of guys that have come in with a low motor and they improve their motor. Yeah. And so when you look at that, that is a skill within itself. The fact that I don't have to worry about that guy playing hard.
Yep.
I don't have to worry about trying to light a fire under this guy, because I understand that he brings his own fire. Zion Williamson wants to be great. He wants to compete. And when he goes out there, it's just something about him. Even when you talk to guys that played against him in AAU and some of the coaches, talking to Sam Mitchell, who coached Zion, who works here, he said, this kid just wants it more than some of those other kids. He said, I would see him talking before the games to his friends, and they'd be laughing and joking, and then they'd jump that ball up, and he would try to go tear that guy's head off. And that's the type of competitiveness that you need. That's the type of competitiveness that I know the old school bad boy Pistons would love.
I like that.
I can see that smile on your face, Zeke.
Yeah, that's my kind of guy.
And that's what I think is missing from the game a lot of times, is everybody doesn't have that I just want to go at you mentality. Yeah. Zion's not looking out there to make any friends in between those lines. We can be friends off the court, but once we step on that court, you mine.
Yes.
He's a point forward, so would he qualify at 6'6 for House of Haywood in the future?
Yeah,
he's a power forward. Okay, then we good. No, we claim him as a little man.
Come on, man.
I just want to have him more in the
He could be anything he wanted.
How about another lefty who's been balling out? Ben Simmons, without Joel Embiid the last 7 games, how about this? Scored 20 points in each of his last 5 games, the longest streak of his career.
Okay, Ben stepping his game up.
Carl Anthony Towns and Minnesota Timberwolves tipping off at 8 against the Chicago Bulls. Towns, of course, missed those 14 games earlier this season, trying to lead the Timberwolves out the lower part of the Western Conference. You saw him hit that ball out of frustration. You have to wonder with this team, like, hey, Minnesota, can they get back? Towns showing that visual frustration in warm-ups tonight, Zeke.
Well, you know he wants it, and you know he wants to get back, and he's one of these players that really believes that he's trying to, you know, reach the upper echelon of the league and wants to be perceived in that way.
And winning gets you there.
And he's definitely putting in the work to get there.
Well, listen, man, Towns is one of those players that we know he's dynamic. He's truly special. But losing will frustrate you. And right now, the Minnesota Timberwolves are in a frustrating place. Look at Towns right there, his body language. He just looks frustrated right now. So we'll see what works out for Minnesota. But, you know, good times are ahead for Mr. Towns, because he's still playing well. The team just isn't quite flowing.
We got fantasy coming up later, and watching that, maybe Towns is one you skip out on tonight. So take us to your house, man. What we got going on in there tonight?
Well, you know, it's House of Haywood, where we highlight plays made by the big men. Not just dunks, but good post moves, passes, etc.
Yeah,
whatever you need.
Yeah.
Zeke, this your last night.
Zeke,
this your last night with,
man,
House of Haywood, so we gonna start it out.
I done ate
play
all the
number
food.
Five. Domantas Sabonis with the spin move.
Go for the head fake.
Look at the spin move. Look at the footwork. Spin move.
One,
up and under.
Two.
Which way did he go? Sabonis with the excellent
post. He's left-handed.
Hey, man, he looking like his daddy. Got him. Play number four. God, it's a staple on House of Haywood. The Joker. Look at this passing ability.
Ooh,
Zeke.
Watch the Joker. Hit him late.
Zeke, could you
hit
make a
late.
Pass like that, Zeke?
Hit him late. No, I couldn't dime like the Joker. Not like that. The Joker threw it. Oh, the Joker got game, man. I got to give it to the big Joker. Joker dropping dime.
But he's not done. Now watch the Joker come right now, going to the basket. Will Barton finds the Joker. The quick flip pass right behind the head.
Oh, that was better.
Torrey Craig with the
better,
that's
man.
Why we gave
Are
him
you
two
kidding
plays.
Me? Are you kidding me,
come
Brendan?
On, right behind the head. Torrey Craig knows how to finish off the play.
Oh, head Joker. That's,
hey, listen, man.
That's a funny picture of the Joker up on the screen, though.
Play number three, Daniel Tice meets Giannis at the rim.
Oh, he did.
Get that out of here. Get that weak shot out. Now, normally Giannis, he makes House of Hayward on a positive note, but on tonight, Giannis is the victim. Daniel Tice with the block.
Did he pin it on the glass?
What type of party is it? It's a block party.
And he got the boom box going.
But if you like that block, you're going to love this one. Terrence Ross, the dunk champion, will not be dunking tonight. JaVale McGee says, get that shot out of here. You said, like, one more time. We're going to give you
one
more time.
I like that. I like that.
One more look, Chris.
I like
one more
here
look.
Come
no entry. Staff only.
Ooh.
But play number one. Play number one.
We bring number one. Let me see it, Haywood.
We're going to get a little saucy.
Let me see it. What's in the house of Haywood?
We're going to get a little saucy.
And the number one. What's the number one play in the house of Haywood?
Aaron Gordon off the backboard to himself.
Man,
the thing is, the defense is there.
The defense is there.
Hey, good defense, better offense.
Yes, sir.
He jumped over the red velvet rope. Oh, yes.
Aaron Gordon doing dunk contest dunks in the half court setting.
There couldn't be
another
choice for number one.
Yeah, that's the best choice right there, man. You see it. And even Chance the Rapper likes that one. Even Chance the Rapper was like, what am I watching out there? He's going to put Aaron Gordon in his next rap song. He really is.
Wearing a Dwayne Wade hat. How about that?
That's not the Dwayne Wade hat. That's the Chance the Rapper
Chance
hat.
That's the number three I know.
Listen, man, well, you better learn about Chance the Rapper then. All right? People in Chicago know it as the Chance the Rapper hat.
Oh, I got to get that right before All-Star, huh?
Yes, you
but
do.
Yeah, but that,
yes,
that's the House of Haywood. My big men were making some plays. But how you like that Aaron Gordon play? That
was, I like the Aaron Gordon
play. That
was saucy,
right?
That was saucy. He jumped over the velvet rope. He can come out of the house. He can play a little bit. You know, and I'm going to exit from your house, but when I exit from your house, I just want you to know when I knock on the door.
You can always come back in.
Thank you.
But that's why we had to send you off.
Now.
This is the last House of Haywood for you.
Don't bomb me from now.
So we had to make sure that Aaron Gordon sent you off right with a really fly play.
And I'm glad he wasn't dunking on a little man.
Man, we're going to miss you, Zeke, man.
Miss
man,
you too, man.
We're going to miss you, man.
Now we have to rep for the guards.
I'm
going to
be back to eat some of your food.
This is my guy right here, man.
We're going to be back to eat up your food.
You know, Joker was in your countdown a number of times. Is he going to get caught off guard by Russell Westbrook against the Rockets and Nuggets tonight at 8?
Burning down the house!
Congratulations to Washington Wizards All-Star guard Bradley Beal, who recently got engaged. That's floating all over social media. If you want to wish Brad a congratulations, has two kids, but also engaged. So congratulations to Brad. Zion Day continues right here on the warm-up. He's not the only player to consider for fantasy tonight. We bring in Tim Doyle to help us break it down. So let's start with Zion. $4,500 for the number one overall pick. I feel like that's the greatest value you're ever going to see for him.
Well, I think it's a massive gamble as well. And sometimes you do have to bet with your heart, not your head. I'm going to play Zion tonight just because, man, how dominant was he in the preseason? Only playing 27 minutes a game in the preseason. He was giving you 23 points a game, shooting a crazy high percentage. And like Isaiah Thomas just said, these are the dog days of the season. And he's going up against an old, crusty San Antonio Spurs team. And he's going to be like, let's just say I know some guys that have, you know, their first baby and they can't leave the house and stuff. I don't want to name names. Chris Miles. And then their first night to get out in the streets, you know, they're so excited. That's what Zion's going to be like on a basketball floor. I expect high energy. I expect some explosive plays. And at 4,500, why not, Chris?
Doyle, see, that's why the number one rule is once you have a kid, stay out of the streets, okay? That's what you have to learn first and foremost. James Harden, 1-for-17 from three-point range last time out. Man, he seems like a guy that was so consistent early in the season, now very inconsistent with his shooting. So is he a guy that you stay away from?
You know, he still got 50 fantasy points on FanDuel in that game, but I'm really worried about the Rockets right now as a whole. They've lost four straight. You saw the video of Harden after the game getting shots up. Westbrook is playing tonight, and I always find it more difficult to handicap Harden when Westbrook is on the floor. I just think this is a massive gamble tonight because I think Houston's starting to realize that Westbrook, Harden, Clint Capella all right, do we have enough other weapons? And I feel like Westbrook and Harden are putting a little bit too much pressure on themselves. I get it. The guy's been unbelievable from a fantasy perspective over the last few seasons. So if you want to play him, go out and play him. Myself, I'm going to stay away because I think Houston right now is in kind of a bad place.
LeBron James at MSG tonight, last time out, just 15 points and a huge loss against the Celtics. He's at 11-5. That seems like a low number for LeBron James.
Yeah, is he going to play in the fourth quarter? You know, that's always the fear when you go up against the Knicks, right? Because this is a game that could be a 30-point game. He's had some memorable performances there. But I think a bigger concern for this individual game is getting a guy like Anthony Davis going. He only played 23 minutes, only took 7 shots. Like, LeBron has proven his point. Like, we know how good you are, buddy. Like, if he really wants to go out and get 45 or 50, I think he can go out and get 45 and 50, especially against this matchup against the Knicks. So it's always hard to get inside of a guy's head who's in his 17th season. And if you add in his playoff years, this is his 20th full season in the NBA, right now leaving the NBA in assists. But little known fact, Chris Miles, I myself suited up at Madison Square Garden. That's right. I played at St. John's. Many times I sat on the bench there next to an Anthony Glover or Kyle Cuff. And now my kids ask me, you know, what type of fantasy player was I? And I tell them this, Chris, I was a 30, 30, 30 guy. They go, what does that mean? I say, when we were up by 30 or down by 30, I got in for like 30 seconds. So those are my stats when I played at the Garden. But I get if you want to play LeBron, I would not have played myself when I was at St. John's.
Can we pull that back up? Is that possible? Because I have to point something out in that picture. Because one, I don't know if that's really you. It seems like it might be Photoshopped. Two, I noticed Anthony Glover was also my high school teammate, and I imagine that you didn't want to make the wrong move next to that guy because Glover was known for if you're losing a game, that's not the kind of guy you want to face.
I knew this. You see, I had the warm-up on, but I always sat close to the coaches because I was like, maybe they'll put me in if I just sit closer to them.
I don't think that worked well for you. I don't think that worked well. Didn't work well for me either. Okay, Ben Simmons, 84 fantasy points on FanDuel. Joel Embiid still out. Ben Simmons averaging 24 while Embiid has been out. Seems like a guy worth the money.
No doubt. And I think really a revenge factor because last year I dove inside of the Eastern Conference semifinals. And frankly, he did not play well against the Raptors. Chris, he averaged 11 points in last year's Eastern Conference semifinals, 7 rebounds and 5 assists. And he's been going nuts his last 5 games. 24 points, 10 rebounds, 8 assists, and 2 steals. Now, obviously, no Embiid out there. No Jimmy Butler, who was out there. No J.J. Redick. Those guys took a lot of shots last year in the playoffs. But I think this is a game where Ben's really rolling from a confidence standpoint. 5 straight games that he has 20-plus points or more, obviously still not shooting the 3, but playing like this is his team. And now that there's room to move on the floor, I think Simmons is must play tonight.
All right, let's see your Doyle's Daily starting lineup. Let's get that revealed.
Well, Ben was crazy against the Nets. Let's hope he keeps it up against the Raptors. Booker, he's averaging almost 40 over his last 4 games. I love Brandon Ingram. I think that was the best thing that happened to the Pelicans. Zion getting hurt. Ingram has emerged as a go-to scorer. Barton's an excellent rebounder. His usage is going to be up because of all those injuries. Hopefully Marcus Smart hits 11 threes again tonight. I think Turner's a basement bargain deal. Kendrick Nunn always seems to get 20 rebounds, assists, not so much, but he's a bucket getter. Marketing, and there's Zion Williamson. So the curious thing is, I wonder if they shut him down, Zion, as the season wears on. The Washington Nationals did that to Steven Strasburg in 2012, and they took a lot of heat then. 7 years later, they won a World Series, and Strasburg was the MVP. So it's going to be really interesting with David Griffin and the Pelicans do.
7 years is a long time. I don't know if one really worked out for the other.
He got a title in D.C.
Which is a great title for them to get, the first in the franchise history. So I get what you're doing. New Orleans Pelicans trying to win a championship as well. Doyle, thanks for stopping by. I noticed you didn't have a guy that cost more than 10 grand. That's the way to appropriate your funds properly. And Kemba Walker knows how to distribute well for the Boston Celtics facing the Memphis Grizzlies and Ja Morant. Talk about a point guard battle to watch. Ooh, that's a good one.